Hello Charlie viewers, I am DS, your psychologist, and welcome to another episode on Channel NITT. So this is another defense mechanism episode, and we're going to continue talking about defense mechanisms. So previously, we have already covered two defense mechanisms, projection and denial. If you have not watched them, do watch them first, so you have a better understanding of what defense mechanisms are. Now, some psychologists even go so far as to classify defense mechanisms according to levels. So I'm going to tell you a little bit about these levels of defense mechanisms. Right at the lowest level, we have level 1 defense mechanisms, which are also known as pathological defense mechanisms. So the word pathological means it's not healthy. So immediately, these defense mechanisms are considered to be totally unhealthy. One such defense mechanism would be denial. Yeah, boo, I like it. You know I can't deny it. Why is denial pathological? A person who engages in denial may totally lose touch with reality because they refuse to accept reality. This is definitely unhealthy, even in the short run. Okay, let's go to the next level. Next, we have level 2 defense mechanisms. These defense mechanisms are labeled as immature defense mechanisms. I admit that I've been a little immature. And one of the defense mechanisms that we have discussed that belongs to this category is projection. Immature defense mechanisms are defense mechanisms that are going to help the individual in the short run, but the excessive use of these defense mechanisms will be detrimental in the long run and may even result in this individual having or developing mental problems. So as a matter of fact, many psychologists, especially those in the psychodynamic tradition, believe that the excessive use of defense mechanisms is actually the cause of mental health problems today. So what this means is that we must really watch ourselves and ask ourselves if we are really engaging in defense mechanisms. However, as already explained in our very first episode on defense mechanisms, these happen usually unconsciously, without our conscious awareness. One thing, I don't know why. So this can be a little bit tricky. Nonetheless, we can always lend a helping eye to the people around us and check if they are using defense mechanisms. And this is how our series is going to help you. So let's move one level up now to level 3 defense mechanisms. Level 3 defense mechanisms are known as neurotic defense mechanisms. So neurotic defense mechanisms are mechanisms that help the individual in the short run to avoid having to confront threatening anxieties. But in the long run, neurotic defense mechanisms might pose social problems for the individual using them, and it also hampers the individual from really enjoying their life fully. And tonight, let's enjoy life. So right in this episode, we are going to introduce to our viewers one such defense mechanism that is classified as a level 3 defense mechanism. And that will be reaction formation. Of course, there is still a level 4 defense mechanism. And when we come to that later down the road, we will talk more about this level 4 defense mechanism, okay? Meanwhile, let's just go back and talk about reaction formation. Reaction formation happens when emotions and impulses that are anxiety producing or perceived to be unacceptable are mastered by the exaggeration of the directly opposing tendencies. This is really a handful, right? So let us first explain what directly opposing tendencies refer to. So to understand this concept of directly opposing tendencies, we have first got to understand that instincts and their derivatives are usually opposing pairs. So for example, love and hate is a very common opposing pair. So another opposing pair would be life and death, submission and dominance. So according to this theory, when one of these tendencies become very anxiety producing, then what actually happens is the ego tries to sidetrack this opposing tendency by focusing totally on the opposite. So if love is giving you a lot of pressure or anxiety, then what you might do is to start to hate. So that is what reaction formation really is. So let me give you three examples to illustrate the concept of reaction formation. So for example one, let's imagine this woman who has to accept that her husband has a child outside their wedlock. Creeping with she says she's 3 months pregnant and she's keeping it So deep inside, she might really hate this child. However, she might also have anxieties as a mother that she should not be like this. So this woman might engage in reaction formation. The opposing tendency is hate. So she might totally go to the opposite end, which is love, and flourish this child with excessive love. It is also possible for us to go from like to dislike. So in our secondary school days, we might have a lot of puppy love cases. So a particular girl might really like a guy a lot, but she feels that this guy will not like her back because she has a low self-esteem. So this girl might use reaction formation and go from the opposing tendency, which is like, to the other end, which is dislike. So she starts to dislike the boy. Every time the boy starts approaching, she will look away or she might even walk away. And she will tell her friends that I totally dislike him. However, actually it all started because she really likes him. So this is another classic example of reaction formation. So peeps, if somebody seems to be irrationally disliking you and you couldn't find a reason to that, it could be because they really like you and they are using reaction formation to cope with that kind of anxiety. One last example of reaction formation that I am going to talk about is internalized homophobia. A person with homophobia does not have a phobia for gay people. It's just that they really, really detest and hate gay people. So internalized homophobia is a type of reaction formation because the individual who has it actually is gay. So this person who is a closeted gay may have a lot of anxieties built up because being gay to him is totally unacceptable and he will not accept this. The anxieties will actually cause him to go to the opposite end to oppose being gay or oppose gays in general. So one interesting to note about these people with internalized homophobia is that their actions are really exaggerated. So they might even front a protest against gays. And the ironic thing is, they are gay, but it's just that they can't accept it and they defend themselves using reaction formation. As I have mentioned earlier in this video, excessive use of defense mechanisms is not healthy and may even result in mental health issues. We will be producing many more videos on defense mechanisms, so watch out for that. And if you have not subscribed, do consider subscribing to us so that we can continue to add value to you. The thunder agrees. Okay, I'm going to sign off now and I look forward to see you in my next episode. Goodbye!